I had this dream. I retired. It's time for me to move away from the game of basketball. I became a weak-hitting double-A outfielder with a below-average arm. I had a $16 meal per day. I rode from small town to small town on a bus. And then I returned to the game I loved. I shot 7-for-28. Can you imagine it? Nah.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Glass City. I'm back at it with another video today. Got another review for y'all. A lot of y'all probably ain't seen this shoe, or y'all might have seen this shoe already. A lot of people didn't get this shoe because it wasn't even a U.S. release. So I actually had to order these shoes from Paris, matter of fact, Europe, wherever you want to say it. And I had to pay some extra bread for it. So I'm going to present to y'all the... let me do this. Like that. See that? It's an Air Jordan 10. Now, if you a sneakerhead, you already know what shoe this is. Paris 10. Now, this is like the only exclusive shoe that I have in my collection. One of the only exclusive shoes that I have in my collection. This is part of the City Pack International releases, where Jordan made, you know, he got the United States City Pack, where he did New York, Sacramento, and all that. But now, for I think it was around 2016, he did international releases, where he did the London 10, the Paris 10, Rio 10, which I really wanted real bad, and Rio 10 is actually easy to get. These was about the hardest ones to get, so these ones pretty much they're pretty much exclusive for real. This actually is a real exclusive shoe. I ended up paying with the exchanges between currency, so I switched from USD to Euros. I ended up coming out of like 310 or 320 altogether, which is a lot when the shoe was only 164 at retail price, so I ended up paying a lot for these. Plus, I got them after they sold out. So, yeah, I like the colorway on this shoe. Real nice. It got like a Fuchs Stingray leather, like the OVO 12, except for the OVOs. Well, the general release OVOs actually is not real Stingray leather, but they got another pair of OVO 12 that they came out with that actually is real Stingray leather. It was a friends and family release pack, so you couldn't even get those. But yeah, I like how I got them purple hits, like the purple hit on the back of this tab right here. On the inside, you got, I don't know if you see that, but it said like Air Jordan in there. Kind of remind me of the Bel Air, like theme kind of thing in there. Then the inside, you probably can't see in the inside pretty good, but it's a purple Jumpman in there. Then you got your size on the side right here, size 9, like the size thing. Then you have a 7.5, and I'm guessing that's Paris area code or something to do with Paris, but you got a 7.5. But what sticks out the most and the most detailed thing about this shoe is this is what kills it right here. You rarely ever see, matter of fact, this might be the first 10 I ever seen with a clear bottom like this. I ain't never seen a 10 with a clear bottom like that. So this might be the first 10 that actually has a clear bottom like this. But yeah, real dope shoe. The bottom is what sets it off for me. That's what really made it stand out to me. That's what I liked it about it. And then, as you know, you got the achievements on the bottom, which is 94 Beyond, 93 MVP Championship, 92 MVP Championship, 91 MVP Championship, 90 scores, 69 points, 89 all defense, 88 dunk champ, 87 scoring title, 86. 63 points, and then 85 rookie of the year. So you got that. Then you got black Jumpman right there on the bottom on the rubber part of the sole. But that clear bottom really sets this shoe off. It ain't really too much to say about this besides that this was one of the hardest pickups to get, actually. And I had to order this from, you know, a different size, so I had to know my exact size. But the guy I got these from, I did a couple trades with him, and I know he legit because it came with the receipt, and I ended up losing my receipt moving. But as you can see, I like to have my laces loose like this. You know, that's how I like to have my laces. But y'all tell me what y'all think about these. If y'all could, would y'all cop them? Y'all consider this an exclusive release or just something general release to y'all. You know, y'all let me know. To me, this is about the hottest 10 I got. This is my first 10. That's the only 10 I ever got. I ain't got no more 10s besides this one. I'm looking to pick up some more 10s. He ain't been really, Jordan ain't really released a lot of 10s. I want to see the Powder Blues come back. I want to see the Chicago and the Nickel, what they call? Nickel something. I know they call it the double nickels. I want to see them come back. But, yeah, then you got, I got to tell y'all, like, you got your leathering on here on the tongue, and then you got Air Jordan on there too, like right there on the tongue. And really, that's all the detail that's on this shoe. One thing I like is when you got lighting on it, it stands out. Matter of fact, let me do this real quick. Boom. So when you got a lot of light on it, it reflects. That's what I like about it, the reflection part of the shoe. That stands out a lot. That's dope to me. But that's it. I'm gonna wrap up this. Here we go. See, this how much the original. That's how much the original price was. $154. On the Sorry, y'all. I had got interrupted. My boy called me, but I'm not gonna edit that out. I'm gonna do some editing, but I'm not gonna redo this video because my boy called me about hooping. So we about to go play basketball, but I just want to say thanks to my followers, man. Thanks for hitting me up. Thanks for thank y'all for supporting me, liking my videos. I ain't getting as many views as I got from that 11 video when I did the part of the I almost called it part of 11, but the UNC 11. But thank y'all for I do this for fun, so I mean, this is the hobby to me. So I really appreciate the views I do get. You know, some people don't get no views, so I appreciate the views I do get, the subscribers I have. Continue supporting me. Tell me, like I said, if I'm doing something wrong, don't tell me, but go ahead and tell me, you know, so I can switch it up. Now, if it's some nonsense, I ain't gonna listen. But if it's something that I think I really need to improve on, y'all let me know. I know a lot of people like them intros I do, so I'm gonna continue to do those, even though sometimes it don't match the shoe, it's just the theme behind the commercial of that shoe, so that's why I do it. But shout out to my boy Get It For The Low. He got a YouTube channel. Y'all should go check him out. For the people that is listening, he told me that in a comment that if they did a Kobe Bryant movie, I shouldn't miss the role because I look like Kobe. I mean, I get that a lot. What y'all think? Do I look like Kobe? I mean, a lot of people tell me I do. Well, I think I look like number 8 Kobe. But shout out to him for that. Shout out to my boy Duval Sneakers, Eastbound Kicks, Ringo Kicks. Am I missing anybody? Holy Souls. They also are Toledo natives like me, so shout out to them. Continue to do y'all thing. I'm gonna continue to do my thing. I'm trying to hold up my promises, saying I'm gonna, you know, continue my content. But that's all I really gotta say for real, man. Give y'all one more spin around of these bad boys. Get y'all working with. And that's it, y'all. I'm gonna catch y'all with another video. Stay tuned.
Hey, what's up? Yeah. Yeah, I'm on the east side. Alright, let me play it back.
Gassed up, shawty. Said I need about 40. Pull up to the party. So turned up right now. Bad bitch, super thick, that's the way I like it. I know all about your tricks, so don't you fucking try it. Leave me alone, let me get this bread. All I want is a crib and a super head. Becky, yeah, I'm